What's the emoji on your phone that you use the most? Very millennial question.
Hugs, hugs, hugs.
A lot of heart emojis.
Lovely. Hello everyone. For TM Fellowship this month, we have Chef Manish Mehrotra from Indian Accent and Chef Prateek Sadhu from Mask. While this was supposed to be an in-person interview, the current situations resulted in a virtual call. So here we are, and we couldn't turn this into an email before you ask us. So chefs, are we ready for your rapid fire?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Are we getting any hampers after this?
I wish. I really wish I could send you a hamper, but soon. Definitely, we'll send you one. Don't worry. Okay.
With Karan, you know, whosoever wins gets a hamper. So I was expecting a hamper.
Yes, I'll give you a hamper. I'll definitely make sure that a hamper comes to you now. What is one of the things you would put on your bucket list?
Meal in a new 11 Madison Park. How well they are doing to do a vegan taste, vegan menu also.
Yeah,
like they've just changed, so it's a bit curious about it because I am the one who don't really do like I'm not a big vegan guy, but especially in Indian cuisine, I really want to see how he's going to do. So that's the latest thing which I want to put it on my bucket list.
I just want to go back to Ladakh for many reasons, and of course see my family, but also. Because this time every year used to be my regular Ladakh trip, just for a lot of reasons, because of ingredients and other things. I think that would be the first thing to go to right now.
If you could be any flavor of ice cream, what ice cream flavor would you be and why?
Vanilla. Versatile, loved by everyone, and can be modified into anything.
And for me, I think chocolate and coffee both put together. And I think these are the two things that, you can't really go wrong with it, coffee and chocolate.
Do you have a song that you listen to when you are cooking at home?
Look, there are many songs which you listen to. In the evening, you are doing some kebabs with your whiskey, then definitely ghazals and all. And if you are doing a quick salad or pasta, then maybe Die Straight or Billy Joel is fine, I think.
I varies between the two spectrums. One, you just go full Punjabi, which also which is the normal theme in our kitchen also, because we have a system in the kitchen where it's, the song, there's always music playing in the background.
What is your breakfast routine every single day?
Breakfast routine, definitely to start a day with a cup of tea. I'm a tea person, I'm not a coffee person. And normal Indian breakfast. Most of the time, it is South Indian with either idlis or dosa. I prefer that. I love to do that.
I'm not a breakfast person at all. I don't eat breakfast at all. My first meal of the day is at noon. But if I really have to pick, so anything to do with eggs.
What's the emoji on your phone that you use the most? Very millennial question.
Hugs, hugs, hugs.
A lot of heart emojis.
Lovely. What's your favorite food emoji?
Is there food emojis also?
So many.
See, that's I don't usually use food emojis. I really don't know.
Eggplant.
Okay, what's the food trend you just don't get?
Vegan as a trend, I don't like it. But vegan as a medical problem, it's perfectly fine.
For me, I don't understand the trend of plant-based meats. And it's very personal because I feel like, if you really have to eat meat, then rather eat meat. And, if you have to really eat plant-based meats, then rather eat like good vegetables. And I don't see it as a farm. So I don't get that. I mean, I really don't understand it also.
What is one food you wouldn't want to ever give up?
Maggie.
I'll come back to rice because for me, it's comfort.
Morning, noon or night person?
More of a night person.
Yeah, if you ask any chef, I think, you'll get a very clear answer. It's night.
Okay. That is the time you get time.
Yeah.
Hard or a soft boiled egg?
Soft boiled egg.
Soft.
Chocolate or caramel?
Caramel.
Both.
How do you like your steak cooked?
Medium rare.
Medium rare.
What was the last film you watched?
I watched a South Indian dubbed Hindi movie. Dubbed Hindi in Hindi. That's it, yeah.
Chef Prateek?
I've been watching a lot of shows. I'm watching a South Korean show, like a Korean show, K-drama.
Oh, and you're into K-dramas now.
Yeah, I mean, I think my wife watches it a lot, so that's how I got hooked to it. But I feel like they have, like, it's quite interesting, actually, the way, like, everything is and the plot and the drama. So, yeah, it's K-drama for now.
Weapon of choice in the kitchen?
Knife. Always.
I mean, see, you use the word weapon. I mean, I would go with sword.
You don't have sword in the kitchen. So, knife and if you are less dreadful, then tandoor ka sharia. That is used a lot in my kitchen.
Millennial trends, yay or nay?
I am struggling myself with the Instagram. That is more than enough for me, I think.
Okay. Prateek, what about you?
Look, like, you know, technically I am a millennial. So yeah, obviously yes.
Okay. What's the weirdest ingredient you worked with?
Stinking tofu. Which is like, I did it, yeah.
So in 2018, we went to Arunachal and in the normal sabji market, they had dried rats. So, and they eat it. It's properly dried. It's all gutted and dried. Clean, gutted, dried. So I think that's a little weird for me.
One crazy dish you never want to try cooking again?
Chyawanprash cheesecake.
I didn't.
It was there on my menu when we started Indian Action. I think for a few months. Yeah.
I mean, I would love to try it. I mean, for sure, if it was on the menu.
Yeah, it was there on the menu when we started Indian Action in 2009. We used to have Chyawanprash cheesecake, which was served with badam milk shots.
Oh, not bad. I mean, but I think I'll come back to some dried rats because I think that's something. I think it's disgusting.
A culinary trend you wish stopped existing?
Culinary trend? Kale, at least in India. That using kale in everything. Ab to kale papri chaat bhi shuru ho gayi hai. Like, it's too overrated. It's nothing, actually.
I'm a big fan of avocados, but I think, especially in Bombay, I think we're getting too overboard with everything with avocado.
The funniest food meme you've ever seen on the internet? If you could explain it to us a little bit.
I don't know, food meme or a video of that, something that some guy came up with, the allergies in the restaurant and the waitress is saying, take a taxi or something, can I call a taxi for you? That is actually a real thing which happens in our mind. We dare say it, but it happens in our mind. But somebody will come, I'm gluten-free, I'm vegan, I don't eat this, I don't eat that, this thing. Glass of water.
I like that Gordon Ramsay's idiot sandwich. So he puts the head between two loaves of bread and just calls them an idiot sandwich. I think that was quite fun.
Okay, any parting words, chefs? Would you like to say something?
I would say that tough times, but I think it will pass it on. And for the oil industry, it is really, really tough because we are the one who, they shut it first and we are going to open last.
I'll only add on to what Chef also said is very unprecedented time for the entire industry, but you know, I think for a lot of people, for a lot of restaurateurs, chefs, beyond anything, it has also hit them mentally. Because look, you know, for the past 2 years, we've been doing exactly the same thing, you know. And you know, you also reach at a creativity brink. You're just like, what's next? I can't really even think. So at this point of time, I feel like people from our industry, I think, keep the lines of communication open. Talk to each other, you know, a small hey, how are you goes a long way at this point in time. To your team, to your promoters, to everyone. So I think that lines of communication, to talking to each other, I think that is very important. And keep that open with your family, with your friends, with your colleagues. It'll only help you. And as Chef said, please take care of yourself. You can't take care of yourself, you know, yourself, no one else will. So yeah, that's it.
So, while most Zoom calls don't last, at least ours does. So, this was great. Thank you so much, chefs, for having us.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Here. It was great.